page 166 in this book, and it starts off with even half a year of the sausage machines, and then it ends two paragraphs later, well, with just two paragraphs. And this section is talking about how, well, it's when Jurgis is in prison after his wife was assaulted and he attacked her boss. And so it talks about how it's not really punishing him, it's punishing his children and family. So the first sentence, it talks a lot about Christmas and how they see the joy in Christmas, and that allows people to sympathize with the family and sympathize with the characters, and also some ethos because of the idea of Christmas. And then there's the next sentence. The next couple sentences are more of creating sympathy for the children, so more. And then there was a sentence, after these long sentences, there's the, ah, it was too cruel. And this periodic sentence kind of creates an emphasis of the cruelness of it to the children and how they couldn't celebrate Christmas. And then it kind of turns the focus back to Jurgis in the next paragraph. And one of the words that I thought was most interesting is it calls him the carcass of some animal. And this helps create sympathy for Jurgis again because of the lack of, well, because he's like a carcass. And then the last three sentences have a lot of irony and juxtaposition because it's comparing how he's actually better off in prison because he's fed and clothed and has, you know, heat, while his children, who didn't do anything wrong, lack those things. And so there's a strong logos argument there. And then it ends with a rhetorical question. Punish him then to leave 3 weak women and 6 helpless children to starve and freeze. And so it is effective because it uses pathos to create sympathy for the characters, but it still has a strong logos argument, so it is effective even in the long run because, you know, why should you punish Jurgis when in fact you're punishing the children, not him? And that's kind of true for the rest of the